Let me show how you can build your own background removal tool. And you don't need to know anything about programming, and you don't need to know or have any other experience, to be honest. You just need to follow this video to have this tool up and running locally on your PC or laptop or whatever you have there. But first, let's have a look what this tool even looks like. So this is it. That's basically it. As you can see, it has its own web user interface, and it's pretty basic, but that's what I like, because it has only one purpose: to remove the background from a chosen picture, which means there is no need for a million buttons and a very complicated user interface. And let me just add, this is running on my local machine. As you can see, localhost means I don't connect to anything outside of my network. This is basically running on this machine. And as you might have noticed, I use Ubuntu desktop operating system, but you can do the same on Windows, on Mac, or on any other operating system where Docker can be installed. And in fact, Docker can be installed on almost anything, so it doesn't really matter what operating system you have on your machine, on your laptop or PC. And how it works? I don't think I have any pictures here, so we might have to download one quickly. I will just Google cat and I will search for images. We've got some lovely cats. What about this one? Let's save that one. Now the picture should be in my downloads, so I can go back to my tool, and I noticed I can click anywhere I want. I don't have to even click on those icons. Or you can also drag and drop. So let me click somewhere here, and now I can choose the file that has just been downloaded. I select it, I wait for a few seconds, and you will see what happens. Now, new file just showed up. And if we click on that, you can see it's exactly the same cat, but with the background removed. I realized maybe that wasn't really challenging for the program, because this cat has already beige background anyways. Maybe let's pick this, or maybe let's search for elephant. What about this one, first one? Let's save the elephant, and let's go back to our tool, and this time we can pick the elephant picture. Now I click select, wait a few seconds again, and shortly already there. You can see new file has been created. Just to confirm, if we click elephant, that's our original picture. And if we click the new file that has just been created, it's the same elephant, but again with background removed. Okay, I think that's it. We know how it works, we know what it looks like, so let's build it from scratch now. I will close that, I will move that window away, and this is another Ubuntu instance, but this Ubuntu doesn't have anything installed, it doesn't have that program. We will build it from scratch on this server. And how do we even start doing it? We have to go to Google, and I will search for rembg web app tutorial. And maybe I will add GitHub as well, because that's exactly what we want. And no, it's not my project, if we click that. We can see the author is Jeff Delaney from Fireship. It's his repository, so it's his project, but we are okay to use it. And basically, you can read the README file and some instructions. You can see exactly what is there, the entire code. But what we want really to do here is just click that button with the code. And there are various ways to download this repository. I will just download as a zip, probably the easiest way. Took just a few seconds, and I will click it again, and I will just unzip it. So now in my downloads, I've got zipped and unzipped version. Maybe let me open terminal. If I go to my downloads, I can see those, the folder and the zip file. Let's cd to that folder, to unzipped one. You can see all files here. You might be interested, of course, in readme.md file, but I will just check Docker file, what's there. But basically, this is the base image for this project. And here is a little instruction. Download this, and this is the link, to avoid unnecessary download. And other interesting thing is that expose. It tells us what port this application will listen on. And you notice that application was running on localhost port 5100. So this is very important information for us, because we know now what is the port that this application listens on. But first, let's download this file. I can just copy that and run command, maybe clear that first, can run command wget and paste that link. Now just enter. I will clear again. And if we check the files now, you will see new file downloaded, u2net.blah blah. All right. Now there is a few commands that I have to run as a root, or if you are on Windows as administrator. So here on Ubuntu, I will just do sudo su. So now I'm running as a root. And first command I need is to install Docker, because what we are going to do, we are going to build a Docker image, and all these files will be included in that image. So on Ubuntu, it's apt install docker.io. Obviously, if you are on Windows or Mac, just Google how to install Docker. I will click enter. Okay, so Docker is installed. Or maybe I installed it, but I can't remember. But basically, even if you didn't have it, after running this command, you will have it installed. Next, we can build the Docker image. But it's important to be in the same folder still. I am here in my home, Marek, downloads, in the unzipped folder. Now let me clear again. The command I need is docker build dot, and that dot means build a Docker image based on the Docker file that is located exactly here in this folder. And then we can add dash t, which is tag. Tag means whatever we want to call it. And maybe we will call it, you can call it whatever you want, but maybe let's call it rembg, remove background. Now I click enter, and the image is being built. You can see from Python, it will download all the necessary dependencies and images, etc. All we have to do is wait. Awesome. It took maybe 2 minutes or so, but you can see successfully built, and this is the image ID, but we also created that tag, which is much easier to remember, which is rembg. But that means if we run now docker images command, we can see a new image that was created. I can see I have some old ones, but we can see that image tagged as rembg. Awesome. Now we can just run it. Let me clear again. And there are many ways you can run it, but I think the easiest one is just docker run dash dash network host, this is simply the type of the network, and dash d, the tag we gave for our image, which was rembg, remove background. Now just click enter. It will display that long string, but you can also check if you want. You can run command docker ps. You can see our image has been running for 28 seconds. What that means, we can now connect to our application. Open new tab, and we type localhost colon 5100. We have exactly the same application as we did on the other Ubuntu server. Now you can just, I haven't got any pictures here, but you can basically perform the same operation as we did at the very beginning. So I hope that helps, and that's all I wanted to show you today. Thanks for watching.